Brookhaven's Accelerator Test Facility started in the early 1990s. It has provided a number of accelerator demonstrations that have been useful for the field as a whole to move accelerators forward and to provide unique capabilities for the community of users that relies on accelerator capabilities. We also support a major laser capability, which is a long wavelength IR laser, a laser with a wavelength of around 10 microns. The laser capability that we have can be brought into synchronization with our electron beams. So we've been able to study a number of physics effects where the two interact.
The most common thing between accelerators and lasers, that both of them produce very directed, intense beams of light or particles that could be tightly focused. And pushed to extremes, they actually provide the highest concentration of energy and electromagnetic fields on Earth in lab conditions. So this means that they are most powerful tools for physical research. And combining them in single facility allows to investigate interaction between particles, relativistic particles, and photons at a variety of physical settings. This opens rich research opportunities.
Since the ATF is a laser accelerator complex, we provide capabilities to users that allow them to make maximum use of their experimental time here. So in terms of the laser systems that we provide and operate for users, we have wavelength coverage from the ultraviolet into the long wave infrared. We have pulse durations from a few picoseconds down to sub-picosecond range. We cover repetition rates from a few hundred hertz up to a few shots per minute. And we provide all of these capabilities at the beamline interaction points. In terms of recent upgrades that we've rolled out at the facility here, we've got one exciting new capability, and that's a new vacuum laser transport line in this experimental hall. That grew out of the need for the laser system to be able to deliver the full power to experiments. In addition, we've also enhanced the pulse train mode of operation of the photocathode drive laser. So this gives users a newer capability to have pulse trains both in the electron beam itself and in the near-infrared laser pulses that are delivered into this hall. And finally, one of the most exciting new capabilities is the Ultrafast Electron Diffraction Facility.
UED stands for Ultrafast Electron Diffraction. It's a technique to explore material state in ultrafast time domain using pump-probe approaches. Specifically, a laser pulse excites the material sample, and an electron pulse probes the material state at a given time delay. There are a variety of materials with interesting dynamic phenomena that can be studied using this UED technique.
Right now, the beamline working as a diffractor. We see the diffraction patterns. In the future, we plan to build a focusing system that will reproduce the image of the sample. So it will work as ultra-fast microscopy.
So we're continuously working on the delivering new capabilities from our laser. Very recently, we finished implementation of two new techniques into our laser. Mixed isotope high-pressure CO2 amplifiers and short pulse amplification. Our CO2 laser is the first gas laser with a CPA technique. We are providing our users with very short and very powerful laser pulse. It's actually the shortest pulse available at terawatt power from CO2 lasers in long wave infrared.
So one of the things we do here at the ATF is we run courses for students. We have this year roughly 24 students that are participating in coursework here at the ATF, learning the basics of accelerator science and giving them the basis for moving forward in their careers.
ATF's role is to help develop accelerator capabilities that can benefit all types of user research.
The future of laser and accelerator technology lies in developing new, compact and affordable accelerators driven by lasers. ATF is equipped to do this research on a smaller scale. We need to first make proof of principle tests of all these ideas. And this is how researchers from universities and industry come here to check their innovative ideas.